Are you bored yet? Did you look away from the screen? Did you check your watch? Did you check your phone? Become more distracted by the cat? Well, you should have. It's believed in the last 20 years, the average attention span of the human has fallen to 8 seconds. The attention span of a goldfish is 9. But what does this mean? Has we as a species just lost our ability to focus? Have we increased the speed at which we process information? Whatever you want to do with these stats, the ever-growing, attention-hungry, sensationalist lunacy that is modern society has changed the way we see, hear, report, and react to the news. And it's time to talk about the future of the broadcast journalist. But before we talk about the future, it's important we know the history of broadcast journalism. It was first in 1920 when people put down the newspaper to endure the exciting electronic world of broadcast journalism when they turned on the radio. Radio grew as a staple of news media for another 20 years when in 1940 people turned it down and tuned in to the first news broadcast on television. Radio and TV grew in popularity over many years until 1979 when CompuServe became the first company to broadcast news over the internet. This brings us to the modern day, where almost 40% of adults get their news from the internet. The rise of smartphones means that people have direct connection to news media from wherever they are, right from the palm of their hands. This has changed broadcast journalism in a number of ways. Where the journalist would once go out into the world to seek information and report about their local communities, they now have the ability to report about whatever they want to whoever they want from wherever they are. Where the viewer would once schedule their lives around the news, reading the paper in the morning and watching the TV bulletin at night, they now have instant access to news media at any given time or place. And now, the journalist isn't the only person who has the ability to report the news. The rise of social media has coincided with the influx of citizen journalism. This means that if me, an average Joe, is, say, going for my morning stroll through my suburb, and my neighbour just so happens to be attacked by North Korea, then I can film it, upload it to Twitter, and have my millions of followers share it to the world. But with these advancements comes consequences for the journalist. The infinite space and worldwide viewership of the internet means that journalists are always under pressure to create new stories. This lack of time to make quality research report can lead to the spreading of misinformation or fake news. The fact that journalists can now report about stories from miles away means that they may lose the art of good interviewing and building strong relationships and community. And the influx of citizen journalism means that sometimes the role of the journalist is cut out completely. This has left many journalists losing their jobs and many more wondering where to next. The important thing to remember is that journalism won't die. Newspaper didn't die when radio came along. Radio didn't die when TV came along. And although social media has brought about many challenges we must face, the news values of consequence, proximity, conflict, human interest, novelty, and prominence will always give us guidelines of what to report. But how will the journalist have to report it? One harsh reality that the future journalist, and even the current journalist, will face is that private media companies must generate revenue to survive. The competitive nature of the internet means that these companies are fighting to create popular stories in high quantity, leading to sensationalist headlines and short stories becoming the norm. So, does this mean the future journalist will have to jump aboard the bandwagon of clickbait? Or even worse, does it mean that these private media companies will die out, and with it, our sense of free press and democracy? And what medium will the future journalist have to report on? Throughout history, new technologies have given us new ways to experience the news. And where a journalist could once excel in one area, the journalist of the future must be highly skilled in all aspects of news reporting. So, does this mean the future journalist will have to know how to create virtual reality worlds and fly drones? Or does it simply mean that they'll learn to shoot and edit visual stories on their phone? Whatever method the future journalist decides to take, as long as there's always chaos in the world, there always will be. There will always be things to report on. Hopefully, this means there will always be jobs for those who report in an ethical, objective, and truthful manner. The scary thing about the future is that we just don't know what will happen. All I know is that I've been talking for 5 minutes now, and frankly, I'm bored.